I try to let patients and their caregivers know that there's always hope. Hope is often ascribed to the treatment or curative phase of a disease, where there's a lot of discussion around ways that a disease can be reversed, be it chemotherapy or medications or surgery to reverse a disease. But over time, those treatments still exist. There's always treatments and there's always hope. It's just the focus of those treatments, the focus of the hope transitions to quality of life and the journey that patients go through. And so it's so common for families to sort of let go of hope and attach it to the treatment aspect of the disease journey, but really what I try to work with patients and their families is to let them know to keep a strong connection to hope from a quality of life perspective. There is hope in having a life-threatening illness. There's still hope there. There is hope in receiving treatments that support a person's pain or nausea. There is hope in spending time with family as a person approaches end of life, even at the stage where they're not able to communicate with you. There's still hope. There's always hope. And that's a more difficult conversation in some cases than others, but definitely one that I aim to have with all of our patients and caregivers.